about you, but my bookshelves could use a bit of an update. Alexandra Gater is here. She's the core editor. And she's going to help us all out by styling our bookshelves properly. And a lot of that is about editing. Now, you've done this.
Yep.
And I'm so happy that you've brought the before shot in for us so we can see she's just like us, guys. Take a look at the before shot of her shelves. So, yeah, there's like, don't act all shocked. Come on. We all have this going on at home. So she took a look at it and did a lot of editing and a lot of styling and came up with this.
Yeah.
Which is just gorgeous. So what do we need to think about when it comes to styling our shelves?
So as you can see by the before picture, I had just kind of shoved everything in the shelves. It was a mess. There was no real organization system at all. So the first thing I did was I organized and I purged. I
just
donated a bunch of my magazines, donated some books, and I just really kept the things and the books that I love. Mm-hmm. And I think one of the most, one of the easiest ways really to update the look of your shelves once you've purged is to invest in some removable wallpaper. So I found this stuff at Chasing Paper. Mm-hmm. It actually comes in a roll like this, and it's a giant sticker. So you don't need to use any glue or adhesive. You just peel it off the back, stick it on. And the genius thing about this is that in 5 years' time, if you're not loving the pattern, if you want to switch up your room, the color palette in your room, you just remove it. And it doesn't leave any residue or anything, which is great.
That's lovely. So easy to cut. And you cut it out into the area you need it for, slap it on there.
It's great. It's
good. And it makes a huge difference. I mean, that's big impact there.
And so let's say you don't want to take apart your shelves and, you know, wallpaper the backs.
Right.
These are also a really great option. So these look similar to this pattern.
Uh-huh.
These are decals. They're from Urban Walls.
Yep.
And they're individual stickers. So you get 140 of them for $37, which is awesome.
Mm-hmm.
Take off all your books and then just stick them along the back, which is great.
Nice.
Yeah.
Okay, that'll take a little bit more time.
Yeah.
But invite your friends over and have some fun with it. You can also put them strategically. You might not, you know, you might want more over there, less over there, but have some fun with it that
way. Exactly,
and
then you have the control of that, yeah.
Now, when it comes to actually organizing, you've done a few key things here.
Yeah.
You've put like magazines together.
Mm.
You've done some color coding as well. This is really important, isn't it?
It really is, and also thinking about lots of layers when you're creating your shelves. So it's kind of, you're kind of not thinking about it, you know, just, you don't want to stack them all in a line how we're used to. You want to add things and you want to add pieces of decor. So as you saw in the before photo, all of the things that I love and that I had just weren't on display. So I thought we could style a shelf together and practice the layers,
So this, so not all the shelves have to have even books on them.
Exactly.
You can just have decor items on a shelf and have some fun with it.
So
are you testing me here?
Yeah, I am.
Okay.
So this basket, $24, beautiful. And the great thing about this is that you can use it to organize as well. So it looks great, but you can also, you know, store things that you don't want on show. So I
That's
put my
right.
scarves in here.
Lovely. Think scarves, sunglasses, anything like that.
And then you want a piece of art. And
That's nice.
When we're talking about art on a budget, I love framing greeting cards or postcards or family photos. So it's a super inexpensive way to add some art to the bookshelf.
Very nice.
So let's put that here.
Okay.
I'm just gonna switch this around, Tracy.
See, I'm already wrong. I was gonna wait until I had all of the objects and then come up with my... Okay, so now we have a flying pig.
Yes. You wanna...
Get
super
one.
Cute, right?
Yeah, no, it's adorable. It's
so
a little piggy bank.
I know, it's a piggy bank.
That's cute.
So you want a kind of big, bold, whimsical element as well.
Yes.
And I've picked gold because it kind of ties in with the gold color palette I'm going for. So let's put that in front of the art print. Again, you want the layers. You want things in front of each other.
Right.
You want things on top of each, like you, lots of layers and depth.
And even if I had a couple of books, I might put my piggy friend on top, right?
Speaking
so
of books,
layer it up.
So
okay, I do have some books. What should I do? Okay, I'm gonna put them here.
Great.
Right there.
Now, the thing about stacking books vertically like this, it completely changes the look of your shelf.
Right.
Because suddenly it doesn't look super cramped, and you have the light colors, so it looks really beautiful.
Yeah, it does look beautiful.
And I have one more element.
So I did that right.
Yes, you did.
Okay.
So again, thinking of stacking, let's place that. And there you go.
Really nice.
It's all about having an eye.
you put a couple of things together, you step back, you take a look at it, you go back in, put a few things together. So it really is a matter of just trusting your gut a little bit, right?
Totally, yep.
Very nice. You did a great job on that. Alexandra, you are the home editor for Chatelaine magazine, and I know that the rug and the accessories are all from HomeSense, so thank you for gathering everything for us and putting that together.